Hello everyone, welcome to Arpita Sharma classes. We are starting the class of important MCQs from geography. Before we start, here is a small announcement. You can access all of Arpita Ma'am's courses on Unacademy Plus by using the code SHARMA20 and get 10% discount as well. Link is given in the description box. So let's get started. So let us discuss the first question. Consider the following statements regarding IMD. Which of the following statements is or are correct? First statement, IMD is responsible for meteorological observation, weather forecasting, seismology. Second statement, color-coded weather warning is issued by IMD from Ministry of Earth Sciences. Third statement, its headquarters is in Mumbai. Options are A, one only, B, 2 and 3, C, 1 and 2, and D, 3 only. So, which of the statements is or are correct? The correct statement is 1 and 2. The third statement is wrong. Its headquarters is in Delhi with regional offices at Mumbai, Kolkata, Nagpur, and Pune. Now, let's move on to the second question. Consider the following statements regarding El Nino. First statement, weak trade winds create El Nino phenomenon. Second statement, failure of southwest monsoon is connected with El Nino. Third statement, this holds an opposite effect on the northeast monsoon. Which among the following is or are correct? Option A, 2 only. Option B, 2 and 3 only. Option C, all of the above. Option D, none of the above. So, which statement is correct? All the three statements are correct. Here, all the statements are correct. El Nino are due to weak trade winds. It will create failure of southwest monsoon, and this hold an opposite effect on northeast monsoon. And El Nino refers to a large-scale ocean temperature-climate interaction linked to a periodic warming in sea surface temperatures across central and east central equatorial Pacific. El Nino adversely impacts the Indian monsoon. Now, the third question. Which of the following statements is or are not correct regarding World Population Projections 2019 report? First statement, India will overtake China as the most populous country by around 2027. Second statement, it is released by Population Division of UN Department Economic and Social Affairs. Third statement, females are projected to outnumber males until the end of the century. Fourth statement, life expectancy in poorer countries projected to improve. Options are option A, 1 and 2 only, option B, 2 and 3, option C, 3 and 4, option D, all of the above. So which one is the wrong statement? It is not correct. So, the wrong statements are 3 and 4. The third statement is wrong. Not females. Males will outnumber the females. And although the overall life expectancy will increase, life expectancy in poorer countries will continue to lag behind. So, let's move on to this fourth question. Here is the fourth question. Which of the following statements is or are correct regarding earth movements? First statement, earth movements are also known as tectonic movements. Second statement, geomorphic processes does not create relief features. Third statement, orogeny is continental building process whereas epirogeny is mountain building process. This is a simple question and the options are A, 1 only, B, 2 only, C, 3 only, and D, 1 and 3. Which statements are correct? So the correct statement is 1. 2 and 3 are wrong. The second statement is wrong because geomorphic processes create relief features and orogeny is the mountain building process and epirogeny is continental building process. Geomorphic agents create relief features. Next question. Consider the following statements about laccoliths. First statement, it appears on the surface after denudational processes. Second statement, they are cooled portion of magma chambers. Which of the following is or are correct? A. 1 only. B. 2 only. C. Both 1 and 2. D. Neither 1 nor 2. So, the answer is neither 1 nor 2. These statements are about basaliths. And laccoliths are large dome-shaped intrusive bodies. It resembles surface of volcanic domes of a composite volcano. It can be regarded as localized source of lava. So, both the statements are wrong and the option is option number D. So, let's move on to the sixth question. Which of the following statements is correct regarding alluvial fans? A. Surfaces making old valley floor or floodplain levels. B. Depositional landforms due to running water. C. It is an erosional landform due to running water. D. Shallow depressions. Which of the statement is correct? Which statement is correct? So the correct statement is B. Depositional landforms due to running water. Alluvial fans are formed when streams flowing from higher levels break into foodslop plains of low gradient. So let's move on to the next question. So this is a previous year question. An artificial satellite orbiting around the Earth does not fall down. This is so because of the attraction of Earth. A. Does not exist at such distance. B. Is neutralized by the attraction of the moon. C. Provides the necessary speed for its steady motion. D. Provides the necessary acceleration for its motion. So, which statement is true regarding artificial satellite orbiting around the Earth does not falling down? Which is right? So the correct statement is provides the necessary acceleration for its motion. This is a simple question. So I am discussing here some basic questions, basic concept clearing questions, which is important on geography. So let's move on to the next question. So this is also a previous year question. Question number 8. Which of the following phenomena might have influenced the evolution of organisms? This is a question in 2014 prelims. So the first option is continental drift. Second option is glacial cycles. Select the correct answer using the code given below. A. 1 only. B. 2 only. C. Both 1 and 2. And D. Neither 1 nor 2. So which is the correct answer? So the correct answer is both 1 and 2. Both these phenomena, continental drift and glacial cycles, have influenced the evolution of organisms. Now this is also a previous year question. The seasonal reversal of winds is the typical characteristic of 1. Equatorial climate, 2. Mediterranean climate, 3. Monsoon climate, and 4. All of the above climates. So, which is the typical characteristic? Or, which climate has the typical characteristic of seasonal reversal of wind? This is a simple question. I think you all might have answered it correct. The answer is monsoon climate. Now let's move on to the 10th question. The 2004 tsunami made people realize that mangroves can serve as a reliable safety hedge against coastal calamities. How do mangroves function as a safety hedge? This is a question from 2011 prelims. So the option A, the mangrove swamps separate the human settlements from the sea by a wide zone in which people neither live nor venture out. B, the mangroves provide both food and medicines which people are in need of after any natural disaster. C, the mangrove trees are tall with dense canopies and serve as art excellent shelter during a cyclone or tsunami. D, mangrove trees do not get uprooted by storms and tides because of their extensive roots. So, how do mangroves function as a safety hedge? Which is the correct answer? Tell me. Mangrove swamps separate the human settlements from the sea by a wide zone in which people neither live nor venture out. Is it correct? No. The mangroves provide both food and medicines which people are in need of after any natural disaster. Any. It is not correct. Mangrove trees are tall with dense canopies. It is wrong. So the option is D. The mangrove trees do not get uprooted by storms and tides because of their extensive roots. So this is the correct answer. So let's move on to the next question. Question number 11. The next question is, why Arctic ozone hole process? A, reduced pollution level due to COVID-19 lockdown of the world, due to phenomena known as polar vortex. C, cooler climate in the South Pole. D, due to polar easterlies. So this is a question from current affairs. I think this was asking previous year questions. So, which is the correct answer? This is the news recently. So, the correct answer is option B, due to phenomenon known as polar vortex. So, what is polar vortex? Polar vortex is a circling whirlpool of stratospheric clouds. It is persistent, large-scale, upper-level cyclones near one or both of Earth's poles. It always exists at the poles but weakens in summer and strengthens in winter. It is not visible or dangerous to humans. So, this is the answer for question number 11. This is a simple question. It is from 6th standard NCERT. When it is 12 noon at Greenwich, the time at 15 degree east of Greenwich will be A. 1 p.m., B. 1 a.m., C. 11 a.m. and D. 11 p.m. So, which is the correct answer? Tell me. So, the correct answer is 1 p.m. We know that those places east of Greenwich will be ahead of Greenwich time and those to the west will be behind it. Okay, east of prime meridian ahead and west of prime meridian behind Greenwich time. So we know that east of prime meridian ahead of Greenwich time and west of prime meridian behind Greenwich time. And Earth rotates 360 degree, so it completes 360 degree in 24 hours. So, 15 degree in 1 hour, 1 degree is 4 minutes. So, multiplying 15 into 4, we will get 60, that is 1 hour. East is ahead of Greenwich time. So, 1 p.m. Right. So, let's move on to the next question. Which of the following pairs are marked correctly? Mountain and place. So the first one, Rhine Valley, place is South America, Appalachians, North America, Ural Mountains, Russia, Vosges, Europe. So the options are option A, 1 and 2, option B 1 and 3, option C 2, 3 and 4, and option D 1, 3 and 4. So which is the correct answer? Which are the pairs that are matched correctly in this question? Tell me. So the right answer is 2, 3 and 4. Rhine Valley is in Europe. Rhine Valley and Bosch are both in Europe. So the answer is option C, 2, 3 and 4. First statement is wrong. First pair is wrong. Okay. So let's move on to the next question. So question number 14. The term Goldilocks is associated with A. The limit of habitable zone above the surface of the earth. B. Regions inside the earth where gas is available. C. Search for earth-like planets in outer space. And D. Search for meteorites containing precious metals. So, which statement is associated with Goldilocks zone? Which is the right answer? Which is the right answer? So, the right answer is C. Search for earth-like planets in the outer space. So, what is Goldilocks zone? Goldilocks zone is an area around a star where it is neither hot nor cold for liquid water to exist. So, it is the search for or the correct answer which is associated with Goldilocks zone is search for earth-like planets in the outer space. So let's move on to the next question, question number 15. Which of the following involves diastrophic processes? First one, orogenic. Second one, epirogenic. Third one, earthquakes. And fourth one, horizontal movements of crustal planes. Options are option A, 1 and 2, option B, 2 and 4, option C, 1, 2 and 4, and option D, none of the above. Which of the following involves diastrophic processes? If you know what is diastrophic process, this question is very easy. This is very simple and basic question from Fundamentals of Physical Geography textbook of geography. So which is the correct answer? So the correct answer is 1, 2 and 4. Earthquakes are sudden movements. Diastrophic movements are slow movements, or diastrophic processes are slow movements. It will take time, but earthquakes, it is sudden. So the answer is 1, 2 and 4, and the correct option is option C. Question number 15, option C is the correct answer. So let's move on to the next question. Question number 16. So here is question number 16. Consider the statements regarding earthquake measurement. It is regarding earthquake measurement. Which of the following statements is or are correct? It's about correct statement. So the first statement is seismometers are instruments used to measure the motions on ground. 2. Mercalli scale is used to measure magnitude of earthquake. 3. Richter scale is used to measure intensity of earthquake. Option A, 1 only. Option B, 2 only. Option C, 2 and 3. And option D, 1 and 2. So, which of the statement is or are correct? Tell me. Is it 1 only, 2 only, 2 and 3, or 1 and 2? So the correct answer is option A, 1 only, because Mercalli scale measures intensity. Intensity ranges from 1 to 12. So Mercalli scale measures intensity, not magnitude of earthquake. Richter scale measures magnitude of earthquake. Magnitude ranges from 1 to 10. And each whole number indicates 10 times increase in power of earthquake. So Richter scale measures magnitude and Mercalli scale measures intensity. Ranges from 1 to 12. Magnitude ranges from 1 to 10. So this is The right answer, option A is the right answer. Answer is one only. So let's move on to the next question. Question number 17. Consider the following statements regarding shadow zone. So if you know shadow zone, this question is very easy and very simple. Which of the following statements is or are correct? First statement, the area where seismograph records no wave. Second statement, it extends between 105 degree and 145 degree. Third statement, P and S waves does not pass through this region. So which of the following statements is or are correct? So this is the question. Consider the following statements regarding shadow zone. So the options are option A, one only, option B, two only, option C, 1, 2 and 3, and option D, 2 and 3. So which of the following statements are correct regarding shadow zone? Tell me. So the correct statement is B, 2 only. It extends between 105 degree and 145 degree. This is the right answer. Option B, 2 only. Shadow zone is not the area where seismograph records no wave. P waves pass through shadow zone. So there is a wave. P waves pass through shadow zone. So statement 1 is wrong. Also statement 3, P and S wave does not pass through this region. P waves pass through this region. So the correct answer is option B, 2 only. This was a simple question. So let's move on to the next question. Question number 18. Here is question number 18. This is a previous year question from 2012. This is a basic question. Consider the following factors. 1. Rotation of the earth. 2. Air pressure and wind. 3. Density of ocean water. 4. Revolution of the earth. Which of the above factors influence the ocean currents? A. 1 and 2 only. B. 1, 2 and 3. C. 1 and 4. And D. 2, 3 and 4. So which of the above factors influence the ocean currents? So the answer is 1, 2 and 3. Rotation of the earth, air pressure and wind and density of ocean water are the factors that influence the ocean currents. Revolution of the earth does not influence the ocean currents. So what are ocean currents? The movements that occur in oceans are categorized as waves, tides and currents. Ocean currents are like river flow in oceans. That is, they represent a regular volume of water in a definite path and direction. So ocean currents are really important. So let's move on to the next question. Question number 19. Question number 19. When you travel in Himalayas, you will see the following. This is a previous year question from 2012. Deep gorges. 2. U-turn river courses. 3. Parallel mountain ranges. 4. Steep gradients causing landsliding. So, what you will see when you travel in Himalayas? Which of the above can be said to be the evidence of Himalayas being young fold mountains? So which of the above can be the said to be the evidence for Himalayas being young fold mountains? So option A, 1 and 2, option B, 1, 2 and 4, option C, 3 and 4, and option D, 1, 2, 3 and 4. So which of the above can be said to be the evidence for Himalayas being young fold mountains? So which is the correct answer? So, all the statements are correct. All can be said to be the evidence of Himalayas being young fold mountains. Deep gorges, U-turn river courses, parallel mountain ranges, steep gradients causing landsliding. Everything given in the question can be said to be evidence for Himalayas being young fold mountains. So, the option is D. The correct option is option number D and 1, 2, 3 and 4. So let's move on to the final question of today's class. Question number 20. Variations in the length of daytime and nighttime from season to season are due to. This is a question from 2013 prelims. Okay. Variations in the length of daytime and nighttime from season to season are due to. Option A, the Earth's rotation on its axis. Option B, the Earth's revolution round the sun in an elliptical manner. Option C, latitudinal position of the place. Option D, revolution of the Earth on a tilted axis. So, which is the correct answer? So, the correct answer is option D, revolution of the Earth on a tilted axis. Variations in length of daytime and nighttime from season to season are due to revolution of the Earth on a tilted axis. So, we have discussed 20 MCQs which are important for geography. These are all some basic questions from NCERTs. Also, I have included some questions from current affairs too. This is basic, but yet it is really important for prelims. Some previous year questions are also included in this. PDF of the classes will be uploaded in the Telegram channel. Link is given in the description box below. So thank you and have a nice day.